100, yeah? So Gordon, I feel like I've exercised a few demons and you've managed to bring me into this environment. The last time I was going to a gym weekly, it was Jim's Calf in Skipton. So where are we today?
Well, we're going to get limbering up because we're going to try and answer a question we get asked quite a bit on the channel, and that is, can you crimp a solid core wire to a regular crimp terminal?
I think the answer is yes. So, yeah, I mean, there we go. End of video. Is that us done?
Well, end of video. I thought, well, yeah, that's a good question. Don't possibly know all the answers. There's a lot of people out there have got an opinion that you'd like to share with us, and in some industries people say you can and some you can't. So we thought we'd just do a little experiment to see actually how much weight can a crimp terminal take.
Okay, hence the location we're currently in then. So we're not working out, which is a favourable decision, I would suggest, on me. And nice to see you providing me with some wonderful snacks as well. So the cables, we're going to work those together, yeah?
We're going to work that with head to head, but I've actually thought, well, what some variables we could have in here, and that could be the quality of the crimp or the quality of the crimp tool.
Okay, and what have you gone with?
We're going to go with a crimp tool. Okay. So I've got my legacy tool here that I have hanging around in the toolbox for years, this Pressmaster crimp tool, and I thought, well, let's compare that with a one I bought at a popular online retailer for a very reasonable price that included next day delivery.
Okay, I take it I've got the reasonably priced version of the tool then, have I?
You're in the red corner, I'm in the blue corner.
Okay, so we're gonna crimp together a couple of conductors. They're 2.5 by the looks of things, and by the setup behind me, we're gonna hang some weights from them.
Let's get limbering up, Gary, you're gonna need that snack.
Okay, so let's do a bit of crimping, and then let's volley some weights onto them. All right. Mine seems all right.
Quality there. Easy to use mechanism there, Gary.
Yeah, like a mechanism, don't we? That's all good.
Nearly as much as you love a pouch.
I love a pouch. I love a snack as well. That looks quite nice down there. I bet it's full of high energy, though, isn't it? I'm not really going to get a chance to burn that off, I don't think. Unless you've got something else planned for us after this. Oh, hang on. I've just popped out there.
Pretty good.
I want to make sure this is good. I'm going to win this one.
I never. You've gone with blue, I'll go with brown, just so we can tell. We don't want to get mixed up.
Yes. Might win one at last. Okay, so I'm in the blue corner. Are you in the brown corner? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, I'm ready. I'm good to go. Come on.
I want to make sure I want decent connections. I don't want to fall at the first hurdle. That's good. Yes.
Right, you ready?
Finally. Fair test.
Two rings.
Yep, two blues. So what are we going to go first? Are we going to try yours against the dumbbells and the weights, or are we going to try mine? What are we going to do first?
We'll go with yours first.
We're going? I'm in first.
You're in first, Gary. Finished lumbering up there, Gary. You ready for this?
I feel like I'm on home territory now, yes.
No stranger to a gym.
Only if it's got a calf in it. So just to clarify then, we know that you can crimp solid conductors together, and we've crimped them together. But the actual task, it seems, is we're actually going to put to the test of the crimping tool, because the crimps are identical, agreed?
Same crimps.
So I've got that reasonably priced one off an online seller. I've crimped my ends up, and we're now going to introduce weights to see which one can hold the longest. And I've got a feeling it's going to be a dead heat, Gordon. First of all, we've got this bar here on the floor, which has completely escaped me from my time at the gym. What's it called?
That's the barbell, Gary.
Okay. I know a few dumbbells, but not this is the barbell. Okay, fine. That weighs 20 kg.
20 kg. So let's start off with 20.
So blue corner first.
Okay. First, right.
Just gently on there. So 20 kg first. And then we're going to bang some tens on. So.
I'm sure there'll be some obscure German standard that someone's going to tell us about once we finish this video.
We like that at eFIXX.
We do.
Gently. There you go. I knew that would hold.
Okay. How confident are you?
I'm going, yes.
We're going straight in with a 10?
Well, that's, you know, when we get to your legacy tool from 150 years ago, yeah. Yeah. So we'll go with that. So gently for a, so this makes it 40, is that right?
Yeah, that makes it 40.
Okay. Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm going to win this one. Right. Joe's not holding me back this time. So let's go.
Should I go with another 10?
That goes to 60 then, does it? Ooh, okay, let's try another 10. If only we'd practiced on your fingers and toes.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Not going to win this time, is it? It goes to 80, doesn't it? Okay. All right, let's go. Yeah, it's definitely going to hold, so I'm all right. I'm confident.
You ready?
Yes.
That's good.
Here we go, and again. This takes it to 100, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, we're 80. We got to 80.
That was good.
We might need a moment just to check the lower regions, and we'll be back with the next one.
Right, ready for round two, Gary? There we go. So that was
gonna win one.
He's feeling a bit confident I'm after round one. So now we're in the.
We're in the
brown corner. So there's yours, Gary. Put that on there. Well, let's not mess around. Let's get straight in there.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't think I can lose. I'm at 80 kg. That's not my personal weight. Obviously, I'm down at about 47 kg.
Personal best. Oh, you're creaking a bit there, Gary.
Yeah. Yeah. It's been a while. These gyms have been closed for months, you know. I'm desperate to get back to them.
Yeah.
Well, right, okay. So that's 20 kg straight off the bat.
Hold on.
Your old legacy tool just about held on there, did it?
Well, we'll see.
Yeah?
I'm ready. Let's
whack a 10 on then. Here we go.
Hold on. Keep them clear.
Stay clear.
We're not suggesting you do this at home. Oh, we're not suggesting you use crimp terminals.
No, get down
to
the
hold
crimp when they open up.
Things up like this. Right. That's 10 on.
So how many is that then?
That's 40.
Okay, mine's gone on. Okay. I did 80. Did I say I did 80?
I think you've reminded us that, yeah.
Done again?
Yeah, let's go in.
Okay, it's fine, is it?
Piling it in here.
What's that then? That's 80, isn't it?
Yeah, that's 80. So we're level pegging now, are we?
Okay.
Yeah, go another 10?
Not really.
Sure?
No. Okay.
You nervous?
Well, I'm going to lose again if this one goes on. I'm getting fed up of this.
Oh, now take it easy.
Win for Gaz.
No, I think I've got more of a dead heat, Gary. You know, possibly I'm slightly ahead.
Okay. I think 80 kilograms would prove the point that the through crimps actually are a really good crimp connection. However, off camera, we've actually proved the reverse, and we've learned some lessons while making this video. What sort of things have we learned?
Yeah, it's not necessarily about the quality of the tool. It's a lot about how you use it, really. And there's some subtle difference between the two tools we've used in this video that can make the difference between an epically strong crimp or one that fails early and Gary could nearly lose his foot. So if you've enjoyed this video, if you've got any other questions about crimps, bob us some questions in the comments below and watch out for more videos on crimps where we'll be looking at some other important things you should know.